The Philippine Trade Department planning to establish vape certification facilities in the country. Now, this move is part of its efforts to curb legal vape products. The DTI adds it will secure additional funding to enhance its safety and certification process for vape products and related accessories. This, as the agency says, its current testing centers could not cover other vape products, including e-liquids and nicotine pouches, due to budgetary constraints. Philippine Agriculture Chief Francisco Tiu Laurel Jr. mobilizes a rapid response team to deliver urgent aid to farmers and fisher folk in Oriental Mindoro. They are the most affected by El Niño's effects. Laurel also urged local governments on the island of Mindoro to officially declare a state of calamity if needed. The declaration, according to Laurel, would enable the DA to extend more comprehensive assistance to affected communities, such as crop seeds and livestock. On Wednesday, the town of Bulalacao in Oriental Mindoro declared a state of calamity due to the effects of El Niño. The Philippine Anti-Graft Court junks with finality a civil case against three corporations created through the controversial Coco Levy Fund. In a resolution Wednesday, the court's second division noted the Presidential Commission on Good Government did not appeal the denial of its motion for reconsideration. In 1987, the PCGG accused the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr. and his cronies of diverting the Coco Levy Fund for their personal gains. The funds were supposed to help the Philippines' coconut farmers. Supermarket operators warning of possible higher prices of commodities and small business closures due to the looming increase in the grocery discounts provided to persons with disability and the elderly. Alvin El Chico reports.
The Trade Department has confirmed that senior citizen discount on supermarkets will increase by almost 100% by the middle of March. From the current 65 pesos a week, the discount will go up to 125 pesos or a total discount of 500 pesos every month. DTI Assistant Secretary Amanda Nograles said even the use of senior citizen booklet may be modified in the public consultation which will be held soon.
Tinitingnan natin kung pwede nating ilagay yung option na ang purchase booklet ay maging electronic form. Ang ibig sabihin po noon, maaari pong unang-una i-replace yung requirement ng papel na booklet, tapos palitan ito ng electronic form, yung maipapakita natin na QR codes.
But supermarket owners warn prices of basic commodities will go up if the bigger discount is absorbed by business owners. Based on the latest census, there are nearly 10 million senior citizens in the Philippines. Supermarket organizations claim the markup for many basic goods is up to 5% only, which will be gobbled up by the senior citizen discount, leaving business owners with zero profit or even financial loss.
Ang unang maaring tamaan niyan, yung basic and farm commodities. Kasi ang mga retailers, sumusunod naman sa tinatakda sa SRP. Kaya lahat ng mabababa o maliit ang kikitain at hindi na sulit itinda, mag-iisip ang mga retailer kung ititinda pa rin nila.
Sa aming pinasa, edi siyempre, ano ba gagawin ng negosyante? May papasa rin sa consumer. So those who are not senior citizens or non-PWDs, oh, sila, they have to bear the brunt of this.
According to supermarket owners, government should shoulder the burden of the additional benefit to senior citizens by giving them tax refund.
Ituloy natin dahil maganda yan para sa mga senior citizens, pero kailangan ang pamahalaan natin gumawa rin ng paraan para ang mga diskwento na yan makukuha ng mga magbibigay ng discount as a refund. Ibalik sa mga retailer.
Sana kung tax deductible, then at least may konting reprieve or may konting relief on our part. Pero sasagutin namin, di para namang sinubsidize namin ang gobyerno, di ba?
The DTI said it will discuss the concerns of business owners with the Bureau of Internal Revenue.
Mahirap naman po na buong-buo ipapasa po sa mga business establishment. So, kinukumbinsi po namin sila, iyon naman po, kailangan po pag-aralin cost-benefit yung maibibigay natin sa senior kung pwedeng pagtulungan ng business establishment at ng government dun sa with respect to the tax treatment.
During the public consultation, the DTI will also decide whether to expand or trim the list of basic goods covered by the discount. It will also clarify if the total monthly discount can be availed in a single transaction if the senior is not able to visit the supermarket on a weekly basis. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.
A new study reveals cash usage in the Philippines fell last year, indicating a shift to mobile wallets in a country where cash has always been king. Now, details from Andrea Taguines.
Payments via mobile wallets now at par with cash transactions in the Philippines. That's according to Visa's latest Consumer Payment Attitude Survey, which saw cash usage in the Philippines falling to 87% in 2023. From 96% in 2022. Mobile wallet usage also came in at 87%, with majority usually going for the QR code option. For Visa Country Manager for the Philippines, Jeff Navarro, this is proof that the cashless wave continues to gain momentum in the country, long after the lifting of COVID-19 lockdowns.
The momentum for attempting to go cashless has remained to be strong, and the confidence year on year has been increasing. In the past, there used to be a big disparity between cash, mobile, and cards. But what we've seen now is mobile payments now is more or less synonymous to the same way as 87% of cash.
Based on the study, 43% said they carried less cash in their wallets in 2023 compared to the previous year. It also found that 83% of Filipino consumers, led by the younger and affluent segments, even attempted to live without cash and were able to manage for an average of 10 days. Navarro attributed this growing confidence to go cashless to the increase in the number of establishments accepting digital payments.
Compared to last year, have you seen an increase in the number of merchants that support mobile wallets? 87% said yes. 63% also saw visibly an increase in card acceptance through swiping. And 52% believe and saw that it also increased for contactless. So dun nanggagaling yung level of confidence on why they now are okay to say yes, I can survive without cash.
Supermarkets, food and dining, and bill payments were the leading merchant categories that consumers observed to have opened up acceptance of cashless payment methods. Catherine Cabaleo is among those who use an e-wallet to pay for groceries and utility bills.
Convenient kasi hindi ka na pupunta mismo sa Meralco, hindi ka na mismo pupunta sa Maynila. Save siya kapag wala kang dalang cash.
Moving forward, the Visa study also showed that 1 in 3 consumers see the Philippines becoming a cashless society by 2030. However, Navarro also acknowledged that internet connection is still a big problem in some areas in the country. That's why he said Visa is also looking at possible ways to facilitate offline cashless payments.
We're trying to work with some of our issuers and acquirers to see if we can do something that's offline. But these are very early discussions. There's still no concrete solution. But it's really one of those that we want to do because it again supports the national agenda of the government for financial inclusion.
He said they plan to be able to pilot a program this year, if not early next year. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
Cancer is still a public concern in the Philippines and remains one of the leading causes of death in the country. Despite this, the health department says the illness remains treatable through early detection. Ara Perez with his report.
Interior and Local Government Secretary Benhur Abalos is not just a guest in the two-day Philippine National Cancer Summit in Quezon City. He also has a story to share, being a cancer survivor. Abalos, who has been active in local politics and now in the executive department, admits he was filled with worries and fears upon learning of the diagnosis, although this did not prevent him from carrying on, something he wants cancer patients to imitate.
Kung nagkaroon ako ng cancer, halos hindi ko na alam ang, siyempre, parang nabaksakan ako ng malamig na tubig na para bang may taning na buhay mo eh. Mabubuhay ka na lang ba na 1 taon, 2 taon, o pinakamatagal ba, 5 taon? Anong gagawin mo sa buhay mo? Paano mga anak mo? Paano pamilya mo? Saan ka napupunta? These are things na talagang papasok sa mga taong, at palagay ko naman ay mararamdaman na isang taong dumaan dito. Natural lang yan, tao ka lang, no? Andiyan yung pangihina. Pero huwag kayong mag-alala, andyan ang Panginoon eh. And of course, andyan ang teknolohiya na tutulong. No? Dahil na-detect ko maaga ang cancer ko, ito'y nalunasan ko po, no? At naagapan ka agad. No? At ngayon po ay wala na akong traces of cancer. Gumaling na po ako. So napaka-importante po ito, kaya kayo nananawagan na dapat bawat isa sa atin talaga, lalo na yung mga may edad na, magpa-test po kaagad tayo.
He says LGUs can do more screenings for their citizens. There is an existing National Integrated Cancer Control Act or NICA which provides for better cancer care and early detection measures. And he believes this can be replicated in the local level.
Not all LGUs are born equal. Eh. May mayayaman, may hindi mayayaman. That's why we really have to benchmark pagdating dito sa healthcare kung ano yung kaya, lalo na sa mga tests. Kamukha ng test nitong breast cancer, cervical cancer, lung cancer. So kung anong kaya. Maraming LGUs talagang they've got a complete program here. Yung iba naman, hindi talaga nila kaya kasi gusto nilang gawin. So ang trick dito ay upuan natin ito, yung nangangailan ng tulong, tulungan natin ang gusto. No? So, at importante po rito, at I would like to emphasize that, it is always the early detection. Importante ang test. Malaman mo kagad ito, no? Ang laking bagay kung stage 1 ka pa lang eh. No? Pwede ka kagad gumaling eh. Pero kung malaman mo stage 4 ka na, kumalat na. I mean, napakahirap pa rin gamutin, hindi ba? So it will make a whale of a difference.
Quezon City Mayor Joy Belmonte reveals they are crafting a local version of the NICA, which may be approved in the second quarter of the year. The Philippine Health Department considers cancer as a public health challenge, accounting for 7.84% of the total burden of disease and the third leading cause of disability-adjusted life years, or DALY. One DALY represents the loss of the equivalent of 1 year of full health, according to the World Health Organization. But life does not have to stop, as cancer is no longer a death sentence, but is manageable and treatable. According to Health Secretary Ted Herbosa, experts agree with this.
Marami sa mga cancers ay preventable and curable basta maaga na-admit or na-detect. So hindi kailangan ng masyadong advanced treatment ang cancer pag early stage. Kaya ang gusto natin, maagang detection, screening kung posible. May mga preventive measures, some of them are lifestyle, some of them are vaccinations. Ang importante, ma-pick up ng maaga para hindi ganun ka-advanced na or complicated ang kailangan sa treatment. Of course, pag-advanced na ang cancer, meron rin tayo mga solution dyan at we're continuously progressing there.
There are already 25 cancer centers in public hospitals nationwide and a private cancer center in Taguig. The Philippine Cancer Center, a specialty hospital for cancer, is slated for groundbreaking this year in Quezon City.
We are in the process of establishing a 20-story hospital. Ito ay sa tulong ng ating gobyerno, sa Department of Health at ang DPWH, sa ating mga legislators. Meron na kang mga groundworks na nangyayari.
The Health Department's Cancer Assistance Fund and PhilHealth Benefit Packages for Cancer are available to help in the costs for treatment of patients. Aside from treating patients, Rojas believes cancer survivorship is also an important aspect of the disease. Medical experts say patients are usually considered survivors when they have finished their treatment. After the 5-year surveillance period, the recurrence of cancer lowers, but continuous monitoring is still a must.
Many of them will have side effects from treatment that they will live with, no? And yet, cancer-free na sila. So, kailangan alagaan rin natin sila at bigyan rin ng tanging attention.
Experts share cancer can be prevented through healthy lifestyle and regular checkups. Meanwhile, being optimistic and hopeful greatly help patients and survivors live with the disease. Ada Perez, ABS-CBN News.